Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. If you wish you could see how wallpaper would look on your bare walls, check no further. I'll show you how to do it. As an example, I provided this photo of an interior room that we'll use for this project. You could pick any room you like, just apply the same techniques to it. I also provided a wallpaper pattern. When you choose your own wallpaper, make sure the example you import into Photoshop is seamless, meaning that when the image is placed side by side with copies of itself, it has no visible seams or breaks. It could be repeated over and over again infinitely. The first step is to create a selection of the walls we'll be placing our wallpaper onto. Before I show you how to do it, to save you time, I just want to let you know that I already created a selection for you so you don't have to do it. I saved it as a channel in the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. You should know how to do it, so I'll show you. First, let's zoom into the walls by opening our Zoom tool and dragging it over the area we'll be placing our wallpaper onto. To reposition it on your canvas, press and hold the space bar as you drag the image. Open your Pen tool and click on a corner of a wall. Release and click on another corner. This makes our first work path. Release again and click outside your document at a position that follows the perspective of the ceiling. To reposition a corner, press and hold Ctrl or Command as you move the corner. Continue to click and release on just the walls, avoiding the furniture and wall hangings. Once you complete the work path, right-click directly on the path to open a flyout list and click Make Selection. Feather it 0 pixels. Go to Select and Save Selection. When this window pops up, just click OK or press Enter or Return. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To fit the entire image on your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Open the wallpaper pattern. Go to Edit and Define Pattern. When the pattern window pops up, just click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll make a new document to create a seamless wallpaper from the pattern. Go to File and New. Make the width and height larger than the photo of your room interior so we know we'll have enough wallpaper to wrap around the walls in the photo. For this example, let's type in 4,000 pixels for the width and 2,000 pixels for the height. Its resolution is 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then click Create or press Enter or Return. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Pattern. Open the pattern fill list of presets and scroll to the bottom. Click the thumbnail of the last pattern, which should be the wallpaper pattern. The angle is 0 degrees, and let's make the scale 20%. Merge both layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Press Ctrl or Command A to select the entire wallpaper, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Open your room document and click the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. Go to Filter and Vanishing Point. The vanishing point grid that you last used will be visible. To delete it, press the Backspace key. Let's zoom into the walls by clicking the Zoom tool icon and dragging it across the area you want to zoom into. Click the Edit Plane tool. For this example, we're going to create two planes, one for the back wall and one for this other wall. Click on the top left corner of the back wall, release, and click on the right top corner. Release again and click on the bottom right corner just above the baseboard. Release and click where you think the bottom left corner is. We can adjust it in a moment. If the grid turns yellow or red, move the corner nodes until the bounding box and the grid are blue. Before we create the next plane, let's zoom out to give us more room. We could either use the zoom tool or press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard. Go to the middle node and press and hold Ctrl or Command, and when you see this icon, drag the grid out past your document. Go to the top corner and drag it so the angle is in perspective to the angle of the ceiling. Repeat this for the bottom corner. Press Ctrl or Command and the plus key to zoom in a bit. Press Ctrl or Command V to paste the wallpaper onto the image. Drag the wallpaper outside the vanishing point blue outlines. Now drag the wallpaper into the vanishing point blue outlines. Notice our wallpaper is now following the perspective of the walls. Notice our wallpaper has its own layer. Change its blend mode to multiply. Open the channels panel and Ctrl or Command click the thumbnail of the Alpha 2 channel if you created it, or Ctrl or Command click the Alpha 1 channel if you want to use the one I provided. Open back the Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the wallpaper. Next, we'll brighten the wallpaper to match the brightness of the room. To do this, click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Levels. It's important to know that adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. If we want them to affect just the one layer below them, we'll need to clip them or restrict them to that layer. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. For this image, let's increase the input highlight level to 192. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.